Our first task was to find out exactly what was happening at the site of the accident. My training as an engineer and as a lawyer had given me a well-developed respect for the integrity of facts, which was to serve me well throughout this experience. As I had in those professional endeavors, I was to instinctively demand much more of my sources than mere opinion, conjecture, guesswork, or contradictory allegations. I wanted the facts as best they could be determined and as quickly as they could be assembled. In the case of TMI, this was to prove a far more difficult task than any of us could have imagined. The utility, its regulators, and other groups and institutions appeared to be contradicting each other, or telling the public either less than they knew or more than they knew. Self-appointed experts began to exaggerate either the danger or the safety of the situation. The credibility of the utility in particular did not fare well. It first seemed to speak with many voices, and then with none at all. On that first day, the utility made its debut by seeking to minimize the accident, assuring us that everything is under control, when we later learned that it wasn't, and that all safety equipment functioned properly, when we later learned that it didn't. And even when company technicians found that radiation levels in the area surrounding the island had climbed above normal, the company itself neglected to include that information in its statement to the public. The company had also vented radioactive steam into our air for 2.5 hours at midday on that Wednesday without informing anyone. It fell to us then to tell the people of central Pennsylvania, as Lieutenant Governor Bill Scranton did at a 4:30 press conference, that this situation is more complex than the company first led us to believe, that there had indeed been a release of radioactivity into the environment, that the company might make further discharges, that we were concerned about all of this, but that off-site radioactivity levels had been decreasing during the afternoon, and there was no evidence as yet that they had ever reached the danger point. Although we continued throughout the crisis to monitor what utility officials were saying, we began to look elsewhere for sources of information which would be more credible to the public as well as more helpful to us.